Hello everyone, I am Dr. Furkan Gözükara. In this tutorial video, I am going to show you the easiest way of setting up your own private virtual private network, aka VPN server or any Windows operating system. The tricky part is that after Android 12, the Android operating system not anymore supports the older VPN protocols. Therefore, now it is much harder to set up your own VPN that you can connect through your modern mobile phone. So with this video, you will be able to set up your own dedicated IP having VPN by using any virtual private server, aka VPS or dedicated server. Here you are seeing the Hyper-V virtual server manager of my dedicated server. I will generate a new virtual server and install a fresh Windows Server 2019 trial operating system on it for demonstration purposes. So this is actually a tutorial video that will teach you everything from scratch on a real server, not an emulation server. I will also show you how to connect from a real phone by using my personal phone instead of an emulator. Setting up your own VPN server has lots of advantages over using free or commercial VPN services. So let's start with generating new virtual machine. Next, let's say test VPN. Okay. You can use either generation. I will use the most recent one. Okay, let's give it 4019 megabyte of memory. And I will connect it to a virtual switch. Okay, everything looks good. Okay, let's pick up the trial. Okay, so this is official Windows Server 19 image that I have downloaded from Microsoft's official website. It is a trial version. Okay. All right, let's connect it. Okay, let's start it. By the way, if you already have set up your operating system, then you can skip these parts in the video with forwarding. All right, I will also pause video here for installation and we will continue. All right, so the installation has been completed. So let's copy paste our password to log in into the freshly installed server. All right, so let's say action. All right, let's type the password. Okay, first of all, we need to enter our IP details so that we can connect our Windows Server operating system through a remote desktop connection and also to connect internet. Okay, it is getting loaded. Let's enter our IP details. You see, I am still using a Hyper-V manager's interface. Okay. By the way, you can't just enter any IP from your mind. You need to use the IP that your server provider is providing you. Yeah, I just noticed that I have entered IP incorrectly. It will be like this. And now our internet should come back. Yes, internet is arrived. And let's fix our remote desktop. Okay, here I will unload it. Okay, now everything ready. And now I will connect this machine through remote desktop management, like right now I am connected. Okay, now we have connected our new server on through remote desktop services. All right, so the tricky part is with older tutorials that you will see, they are using the built-in features of Windows Server. However, now that However, now that modern Android systems is not supporting anymore point-to-point tunneling protocol, and in many of the tutorial videos, I see that they are using PPTP to connect through their private VPNs. And currently, Android 12 in my phone supports only this protocol and
IPSec IKEv2 MSCHAPv2 VPN server. For modern clients, IPSec IKEv2 MSCHAPv2 is now the preferred VPN solution. It is supported by Windows since Windows 7, Android since 11, macOS since 10.11, iOS since 9. Both full tunnel and split tunnel configurations are possible. Split tunnel maybe require additional configuration on the client.
Okay, my phone is supporting IKEa version 2 with MSCHAPv version 2. However, it is really hard to set up this VPN on Windows server operating system. Therefore, we are going to use another tactic, which is very easy to install. We are going to use open source VPN system that we will install on our operating system, which that is called as SoftEther VPN project. It is open source. You can see their GitHub as well, their source code as well in here. So it is totally safe. They have installation file for Windows operating system. Okay, so let's install it in our freshly composed Windows server. Okay, I will change internet settings to download the file. Okay, let's see, where is the download file? Yeah, here. Okay, yes. Okay. I had to add more permission. And yeah, the file is here. Let's download it. Okay, let's install the downloaded file. Okay, we need VPN server. Okay, the installation has been completed. Let's start the server. Let's double click it. It requires a password. Okay, I have copy pasted a password. Password has been changed. Now we are selecting remote VPN server. Okay. Okay. Yes, these are not very important. This is our global IP. This is important. Okay. And we are going to enable this one. This is important to connect through our Android phone. Okay, we don't need this. All right. Yeah, we need to also compose a user, which is important. So let's say username test VPN. And we also need to set a password for it. Okay, I'm setting the password right now. Okay. Okay, the person has been generated, the user account. Okay, there is one another tricky issue that I had to find with a lot of research, which is virtual NAT. So we go back to our users screen. Okay, double click here to go user screen. Then there is virtual NAT and virtual DHCP server, secure NAT. You have to enable this, otherwise you won't be able to connect through your phone. All right, I think this should be sufficient. We have enabled it, yes. Okay, and one final thing. We are going to use OpenVPN, which is another open source software. Let's look for OpenVPN. And you see it's also another free software. Okay, you are going to use OpenVPN application in the Play Store. Let me also show you that. To connect our VPN through our mobile phone. Okay, yes, this one. You need to install this one. Okay, so on our server, we need to export our OpenVPN settings by clicking here. Then you see there is generate sample configuration. I will generate it into, let's say, downloads folder. Okay. Okay, inside the generated zip file, only one file we need, which is OpenVPN remote access. Okay. Inside this file, we need to replace one thing before we can use it in our phone in the OpenVPN application. We need to change this into our server IP, which is, in my case, okay, so you need to change this into your server IP and just save it. Okay, other than this, now you need to put this file into your mobile phone. And now I will move to my mobile phone and show the rest there to show you how you can how to connect your setup VPN. Okay, now we are at my phone. I have downloaded the file into my phone. So first, let me show you my current IP address. As you can see, it is the IP address that is provided through my ISP. Okay, then I am opening OpenVPN application through AppMarket Play Store. Then on this screen, we are going to import the generated file. I have it in my downloads folder. We are going to click file. We are opening through browse, and we are importing that file. Okay, then we need to enter username, and you can also save your password as just I did, as you can see. And then it is ready to connect through VPN by just clicking it. Click continue there. Okay, now we are connected. And now let's see if our VPN is working. Let's return back the browser and refresh the page. Okay, as you can see, now we are connected through VPN. Also at the right top of the Android phone, you see that I was connected with VPN. Yes, as you can see on the left top of the screen, the VPN icon is alive. Okay. Thank you very much for watching. Please like and subscribe. Also leave a comment. Let's quickly review. You are generating a user and setting it a password. And there you are setting up the enabling in a secure NAT, and then you can connect your VPN server with OpenVPN application. It works flawlessly. It is so easy. All other options are so hard to do. This is the easiest way that I have found. Okay, hopefully see you later.